So this is a new adventure here, huh? Welcome, and it's very hot just the last couple of days here in LA. And as you can probably hear, the air conditioning is going. So when I'm speaking with you guys, thank you for coming. I'm going to put the air conditioner on, but when I play, I'm going to turn it off because there's a microphone. Anyway, let me just get started and play some music and then we'll talk a little bit. All right, thanks for coming, y'all. Warm up a little bit here. that's the first piece. So this is the first time I've done this. I see somebody saying invalid address. We'll deal with that later, but here's the info as well. If you can't read it, it's milomon@mac.com for that. And make sure you use the hyphens for the Venmo. Thanks. But yeah, this is the first time I've done a live stream. Anyway, let's talk more later. What shall I play next? This is on the quarantine files that I did last week or a couple weeks ago. Timmons. I'm going to turn the air conditioning on, as I mentioned before. I want you guys to see my fingers more than my face, so that's why I got it like this. Air conditioning. The first piece, by the way, was a song I wrote called As I Remember You. And I'm going to be talking about my collaborator and good friend Rocky Moffitt quite a bit on this concert. He and I wrote lyrics to that song. And I know some of you have seen me do my house concerts. I've done them around the world a little bit in the last few years, in Europe and here in the States. So this idea of doing a live stream is something I've never really been interested in doing. Until now, of course. Everybody's interested in doing it, and musicians all over the place are... I mean, with me, it's like the learning curve in the last couple of weeks with stuff, technical stuff, has been a lot for me, but a lot of y'all have been doing this for, you know, a year or two already. So, anyway... I'm learning, and it's cool. It's going to be good. I see. I'm not going to pay attention to the messages. I'm not used to doing this thing, and I will. They'll all be there for me. I'll go through them later, and we'll talk and stuff. But right now, let me just focus on the music, and I got a few stories to tell you. Cool. Here's another one. I call Invocation. It's actually kind of an improv on two different pieces of mine I'm putting together for this concert. Oh, gosh, I'm sorry, y'all. On that last one, I forgot to turn off the air conditioning. All right. This song, like I said, this is my first time doing this, and also it's hot here in L.A. now. In the 11 years that I got to play with the wonderful band that are still smoking hot, Tower of Power, I got to write for them. They recorded 8 of my songs. With Greg Adams, or with Doc and Emilio, and I wrote one with Herman Matthews, the drummer who I'm now playing with in Greg's band, East Bay Soul. We'll talk about that in a minute. This is a song I wrote with Doc and Mimi called Please Come Back to Stay. That was really a lot of fun to play live. I had a lot of fun with this one. So, it goes with Z. Thank you. Please come back to stay. I'll leave the air conditioning off. let's see, I did this on the... Well, let me tell you a story. So, I was playing a dinner party in the Bay Area. Here, I'll put the air conditioning on while I'm doing this. For some friends, actually, they hired me to play piano. It was a dinner party, but it was friends. And a little preface to this, I was just kind of out of college, a few years out of college, in the 80s. This is before I was with Tower and before I was with Bonnie Hayes. I think it was before I was with Maria Muldaur even. Anyway, I was young. Now, my friends and I heard that there was a film in town that was filming. They were looking for extras. And we were invited to go down to this rock club in San Francisco called the Mabuhay Gardens, which is long gone now. And so we interviewed one by one, and this is how old it was. They took Polaroids of all of us, right? There's a stack of Polaroids high on the table. And gave them our information and made our way out. So a few days later, I get a phone call. And they said, this is the film company. Would you be available to work for 3 weeks every day? And at the time, I was on staff at San Francisco State. And I talked with my Nancisi, the head of the department, dance department. And I was pianist, accompanist, and composer. Pianist and drum. I played drums. Rocky taught me how to play some drums back when I was in college. And so the movie was Rick Springfield, Hard to Hold, and the stand-in for the film got an automobile accident on the way up from L.A. So they picked me out of the stack of Polaroids to be the stand-in for Rick Springfield. Well, there's a lot of musicians, and there's musicians in the crew, and for 1 week we shot at the Fairmont Hotel up in the penthouse, and we jammed every lunchtime, because there was a drum set and piano and bass and everything around there, and so they got to know me, and I ended up doing a date with a string section and a jazz trio that I worked in. That was, the head was lead, Rick Springfield, was serenading the female lead, which I forget her name now. She was a dancer herself. It was a long time ago. Anyway, I left my heart in San Francisco, and they had another stand-in, a Tony Bennett imitator, anyway, doing it in front of the string section, and me and John Goodman and Alvin Sykes, the trio that I used to play with. I don't know, Eric Swinderman, if you're listening, were you there too on the guitar? So, cut back to this Pacific Heights dinner party a couple years later, and I'm on a break. And across the room and in the front door walks in the Tony Bennett impersonator. And I was like, wow, that's cool. I've forgotten his name now. So I'm walking across the room and I'm saying, hey man, how you doing? Good to see you. And as I get closer, it's not the Tony Bennett impersonator at all. It's Tony Bennett. And he's just watching me and laughing. And we shook hands, and actually at the time, John Burr, a bass player in New York, was playing bass with him, who I knew from the University of Illinois. So, connected. Later on in the party, people were asking him to sit in. Finally, he comes over to me. I said, what do you want to do? And he said, anything but I leave my heart in San Francisco. So, I knew this, a little bit of the Bill Evans changes on this one that I've played before. I'm playing the song, My Foolish Heart. Oh, air conditioner. my foolish heart. So, do you ever... I've noticed during this quarantine thing that since we're all isolated, it seems like things are getting a little batty. Sometimes in terms of intuiting, like psychically, you know, things. So I got a quick story to tell you of doing some work in a dream. I was late night in New York City and flying early back to L.A. And I went to see my friends, Ricardo Bond, who I met with this band as well, guitarist, and Veronica Nunes, singing and playing the Brazilian four string, like ukulele thing. I forget what it's called now in Portuguese. Just kind of like down the village. Anyway, it was 1 o'clock in the morning, and I got a 6 o'clock call. I made it to the airport, made it on the plane, and I fell asleep. And then I woke up for food, and I woke up, you know, for the bathroom water. And every time I woke up, there was this melody that was starting to happen.
Thank you. Not working. So anyway, thank you guys for coming. I'm going to do this again.